Hello friends, we are discussing our module 3. Today we are going to discuss our 3rd module, that is evolution. So the module 3rd top first topic is coevolution. My topic of discussion is coevolution. So what exactly the coevolution is, we are going to discuss. So coevolution, first there will be interaction between two species, or there will be interaction between two taxon, you can say. So, coevolution is the evolution of two or more species which reciprocally affect each other, sometime creating a mutualistic relationship between the species. Not always, they not always create mutualistic relationship. Sometimes it may be antagonistic, means some examples I will tell you later about antagonistic. So, this is the basics about coevolution. This is the coevolution. Is the evolution of two or more species which reciprocally they affect each other, sometime creating a mutualistic relationship between the species. Such relationships can be of many types. Okay. Such relationships, it may be of many types. So, with this diagram, you can easily understand. Suppose in any taxon, this is the taxon A and this is the taxon B. Suppose this is of one species of any taxon, this is the another species of any taxon. They both are interacting to each other and they are reciprocally regulated to each other. So, after evolution, this A species will convert into this A and this B will convert into this B. This is the product of evolution. So, coevolution maintain interspecific interaction between the interspecific. Why interspecific? Because there are two species, they are interacting to each other. Okay. Now, come to the this coevolution. So, evolutionary change occur in taxon of one species, create the corresponding change in taxon of other species. Coevolution maintain interspecific interaction between the taxon. An evolutionary change in the morphology of plant might affect the morphology of an herbivore. This is one of the example of the evolutionary change. How there will be change in evolution? So, morphology of plant will be changed. It may affect the morphology of particular herbivore which is dependent on that particular plant. That eats the plant, which in turn might affect the evolution of the plant, which might affect the evolution of the herbivore and so on. Means you can say the plant, this herbivore and the plant, they both are reciprocally regulating each other. So, coevolution is likely to happen when different species have close ecological interactions with one another. These ecological relationships include predator and prey, parasite and host. These both are antagonistic, competitive species, and one is mutualistic species. So, immune complexity in the human beings is due to coevolution. It is all about the parasite and host. Predator-prey model, I already discussed in Lotka-Volterra model. In second module, that is the ecology, I told you in very details what is the predator and prey model. So, in this, relationships formed through coevolution may be called symbiotic relationships. Three type of symbiotic relationships are predator-prey relationships, mutualistic relationships, and parasitic relationships. So, species type of interaction persists for longer time due to coevolution, you can say. So, there are some examples of coevolution, that is yucca and moth. They both are dependent on each other, that is yucca and moth. And second is gentian and carpenter bee, that is floral sonication. Benefit to the flower, defenses against herbivores, that is passion flower and butterfly. Benefit to the flower, mimicry and fakery, orchid and bee. And what about mutualism? Mutualistic behavior is moth and orchid, ant and acacia, fly and flower, columbines and shapeshifts. So many examples are also there, like deep nectar in flower, long proboscis in insects. You can write evolution of different pollinating strategies in angiospermic flowers and pollinator agent. Evolution of prey and predator, I already told you. And evolution of host and parasite, evolution of mutualistic species, it may be competitive also, and evolution of mimicry and human and leaves. So, these all are the examples of the coevolution. So, next point of discussion is, Coevolution occurs when adapting to their environment, two or more organisms evolve together. To make the best of where they live, organisms make use of other organisms by eating them. Make the best use of. Why they make best use of? Because one organism where they live, organisms make use of another organism by eating them or living on them or building a partnership between them. So, organisms co-evolve with many species at the same time because an environment includes many different type of organisms. So, they both are utilizing each other. They are adapting to their particular environment and two or more organisms they evolve together. Not only one organism will evolve, means co means together. They are evolving but co. That is in the same time. Togetherness will be there. Yes. This is the feature of the coevolution taxon. So what exactly coevolution features? So in coevolutionary taxon, it may be related or may not be closely related. It may not be. We can't say about must and may not have common ancestor. So, coevolutionary taxon are present in the same geographical area. And coevolutionary taxon, they may not evolution of the similar traits. So, they may not have evolution of the similar traits. It is not necessary that all traits that are evolving, it must be similar, may not evolution of similar traits. So, some conditions which are very much necessary for coevolution to happen, that is the taxon must be interact to each other. As I already told you, there will be togetherness. So, for togetherness, there will be interaction. So, if any two species, they can't able to interact to each other, then how they both the species can coevolve? So, there must be interaction, you can say it, with each other. And both taxon present in same geographical area. It is also necessary. Means both the taxon, as I told you in this diagram, with the help of this diagram, means this is the taxon A, this is the taxon B, they are present in the same geographical area, then only they can reciprocate or reciprocal regulated to each other, because they are benefiting to each other, benefiting, and they both are co-evolving for their purpose. Okay. Yes, both taxon present in same geographical area. Yes, this is the main point, that is the significance of coevolution. Why there is coevolution? Because with the help of coevolution, and any organism or one organism that can increase their own fitness value with respect to other. Means it may be happen that one species is evolving faster as compared to another, and it also increases species diversity. If two species, they are co-evolving with each other or they are co-evolving together, so there will be species diversity. Okay, species diversity, that is very much important. So, species diversity, this is the significance of coevolution. I hope you all have very well understood about this topic, that is the coevolution. If you feel any problem, you can write me in the comment box. And if you feel any doubt or queries related to any problem, the question which asked earlier in so many competitive exams, you can go through the questions related to coevolution and you can ask if you feel any problem. Surely I will reply as soon as possible. So now it's time to say thank you. So thank you friends once again. Please subscribe to my channel, like this video, hit the like button. And share this video with your friends, colleagues, as more as possible. Thank you.